Namaste. This is the second video of the series on getting the salesperson right. If you have not watched the earlier one, I would suggest that you go and watch that video, because this is in continuation to the concept that you have to get the person right before you get your world right. And the world of a salesperson is the world of the prospect. So before you get the order, before you get the confirmation, before you actually make the presentation, there are certain things within you which you have to get right. So in that video, I had spoken about the physical side of a salesperson. And this video is all about getting the mental and emotional side right before you make your sales presentation. So here are a few questions for you. Have you ever gone to watch a movie, and while watching a movie, you laughed? Have you ever gone and watched a movie, and while watching or during the movie, you cried? I bet out of 1,001, the answer would have been a yes. We all have felt those emotions. So what do you think is the cause for all those emotions? Do you think they would have put something in the seat to make us cry or to make us laugh? Or do you think you saw something, you watched something, you heard something, and as that thing went into your mind, you felt those emotions? I'm sure the answer was the second part. That we saw, we see, we hear, we feel, and that's how we get into emotions. So if a movie can have an impact on us, I'm sure everything which we are doing around, living with in the world, is having an impact on us. So there are five things I'll share with you which will make you emotionally and mentally very upright as a salesperson. There are many things, but in this video, let's focus on these five. The first is, before you go for a sales presentation, ensure that this mind of yours is sorted. It's decluttered. Your mind should not be like a city gully traffic, you know. It should be like a highway where the cars are zooming in full speed. Many times a salesperson has a lot of things here. So he has some unfinished jobs, he has some challenges, he has some communication issues with some colleague in the office. Ensure everything is sorted. Ensure you sort it on a daily basis. So go with a clean slate, because that world of yours, the prospect's world of yours, will demand the best from you. And only a decluttered, only a highway car can actually win that race. So ensure that this mind of yours is decluttered, the windows are closed. Second, ensure that what you read, what you see, what you watch is making sense to your life. So before you see something on the net, before you spend some time on reading a book, before you spend some time on watching something on TV, ask yourself, is what I'm watching going to make me a better person, family-wise, business-wise, personal life-wise? It's going to make me a better person. If not, then I should refrain from watching. Third thing, see if you can learn something new every day. It can be even a word. It can be something about your profession. It can be something about your relationship. It can be something about your process, the sales process. It can be something about communication. It can be something about leadership. Even the smallest of things is good enough for you. But ensure that there is something new happening in your life on the knowledge side. There's a direct correlation between how much we know and how we feel about ourselves. Our confidence has a direct correlation with our knowledge. The third part, be very careful about the kind of people you meet. We keep a rose in our hands for a couple of minutes, and those 2 minutes will leave the fragrance of the rose in our hands. Same is the kind of impact we have of people around us. So choose your company wisely. A salesperson has to be full of energy, full of liveliness. So ensure that the people around you are the ones who can actually make you, build you, inspire you. And the fifth one, the last one is, salespeople travel a lot. So either they are traveling across cities or they're traveling within the city. Make sure your travel time is your energizing time. So have something to read, have something to listen to, have something to watch. Nowadays, data is so freely available. Ensure that before you enter your prospect's office, place, you are so energized, you're so much charged up that you're able to handle the toughest and the most powerful of objections which a prospect can put across to you. But that depends on what you have prepared yourself with before you went into that office. So you use your travel time. Your travel time should become the biggest university of your life. So take care of these five things, and I'm sure you'll be mentally and emotionally right before you make your world right. All the best. Namaste.